We live in an ecology of pranks. It's kind of what Burning Man is built on, that foundation. It's not just wanting to prank other people. It's you wanting to be pranked as well from time to time. It's only fair. Burning a wooden man on a beach is kind of a prank. Art cars are totally pranks. A ton of performance arts and even visual art are pranks, hacks. They can be well done, like Banksy or Dalí, or they can be guttural and awful, like reality TV or whatever it is that Yoko Ono does. Pranks have evolved into culture jamming and life hacking. Who knows? But this is the story of a hack that turned into a bet, that turned into a contest, and finally, the first intergalactic prank. It all started with Jim Mason. On paper, he is a most impressive person. In real life, he's not as impressive. But on paper, oh, he's got a master's degree in Stanford in anthropology and studied mechanical engineering. He got an NEA grant and brought sculptors from the Sepik River region of Papua New Guinea to carve the one-acre New Guinea sculpture garden at Stanford. He was a director at the Headland Center for the Arts. He was also a director for the Rosetta Project and the All Language Archive at the Long Now Foundation, where he archived 1,500 human languages and put them on a disc to be put on a satellite into outer space launched by the European Space Agency. The billion-dollar project blasted off in 2004, and the craft landed on a comet in 2016. Impressive stuff. He is now the president of All Power Labs, who plays with alternative fuels and dreams of receiving the MacArthur Genius Grant. Jim has also made some big art for Burning Man, such as the Vegematic of the Apocalypse. This siege weapon-looking thing is actually a blender. And this piece, the first keyhole piece from 1997, Temporal Decomposition, the most elegant piece of art to this day at Burning Man. It's a 56,000-pound ice ball, and as the ice melted, it would shed clocks. That large metal pole coming out of it is the gnome, the part of the sundial that casts the shadow. There was a clock face on the ground around it. The idea was that time outlasts every timepiece. It was a stunningly poetic piece that was the most work that any crew ever did on any project at Burning Man ever. The only piece that I could think of that was better was Steve Heck's piano bell. He built a castle out of 88 pianos that 300 people could bang on. When it burned, the cacophony of snapping strings and crushing harps was amazing. These are the only known photos of it burning. It was the single most transcendent art moment of my life, and I swear it wasn't just the drugs talking. Jim also had some impressive art failures, like the Mechabolic. How can we forget that? He built a 140-foot-long car that ran on garbage, and it actually drove 60 feet before it completely fell apart, eating over $100,000 and devouring dozens of lifelong friendships. But the one we all love is the Impotence Compensation Project. Wildly dangerous. Totally stupid. Pretty cool, though. Okay, that's Jim. Now, here's the story. In June of 2001, unprovoked, Jim Mason hacked me, Chicken John, by breaking into my mailing list and sending an email to my list pleading for funds so that I could go and do an art project at Burning Man. The project was me standing in the bleeding sun at the gate of Burning Man and handing out 9/16 wrenches to everyone. It was a stupid, senseless prank. It was my fault, really. The password to my list was damn it. Damn it was my dog. But Jim is mostly terrible, as you know, and he did this offensive thing, and I got mad. And I challenged him to a public art bet. I bet him that I, Chicken John, was a better artist and a better prankster. I explained the terms. Each of us goes to Burning Man. No art grant, no big money, no giant crew, just you and your art. Make art that touches each and every person at Burning Man. Videotape it. Bring it to the Odeon Bar after the event on such and such a night. You show yours, and I, Chicken John, will show mine. Applause declares the winner. If you win, you get all my tools. If I win, you have to give me apology art. You say you're sorry with art. And the apology art I want is you saying you're sorry in 100 different languages, Mr. Language Archive Smarty Pants, and I want them all framed nice and hung up in the bar. Jim accepted the bet. I changed my password to Damn It Dog, and Burning Man came, we did our art, and videotaped it. For my video, I tapped my cousin, Nigel, from Great Britain, to plumb the playa with potable water.
Thank you very much. It's still fucking funny. Every time I do it, it's still funny.
I decided to stop by Larry's camp to see how he was doing and asked him if he knew Jim Mason, notable wanker.
You know, we originally invested in Jim as an intellectual property. We're looking to recoup our losses any way we can. I'm hoping that Jim will have a idea that he actually executes and give us a little bang for our buck. I mean, we figure that every participant here, about $15 of their ticket has gone to Jim Mason. So Jim, the cough up. Marion! Can somebody get me some water? I do everything. Marion!
Well, Nigel went all over the plier in his quest to plumb water everywhere. He explained that water is the most important thing at Burning Man, and since Jim Mason usually makes art with things that make fire that don't work, it's only fair that we should beat him in an art bet with an art thing about water that doesn't work. But then I thought, well, what if Nigel messes up? I mean, after all, he is a hippie. So just to make 100% sure we won the bet, Reverend Hal and I went to Reno where they kept the porta potties and we blessed the toilet paper.
Bless this toilet paper and the comfort that it gives in the silence.
The toilet paper that touched each and every person. Unfortunately, I cannot show you Jim's video here tonight. The only family-friendly bit of his video, which was a combination of porn and actual dogfights, is this audio clip.
That's right, Chicken John. While you were out working up a sweat pounding on water spigots, I was having sex with each and every person on the playa. It's amazing what you can get done when you're not trying to assemble 8 tons of bullshit in the name of art. And yes, I do have to admit it was a lot of work, but really, what is Burning Man about if it's not about meaningless sex with people who think you're the Messiah because you built the biggest flamethrower on the playa?
The applause in the bar declared me the winner, the better artist, and the better prankster. But he never paid up. I never got my apologies. I was the king, and Jim was nothing but a serf, a lowly serf. But it was not to last. Remember that billion-dollar spaceship that Jim's language archive was on? You know, the one that is on a comet leaving our solar system? The craft that could easily outlast our planet when you factor in nuclear lunacy? Well, after that craft landed in 2016, he came to me in the middle of a show we were doing and demanded the microphone and told me and the audience that the apology art that I demanded was on the Rosetta disc. In 1,500 languages, it clearly states, "Chicken, I am very sorry I hacked your list with a stupid art project about 9/16 wrenches. It was a terrible thing to do, and I am deeply sorry if I hurt your feelings. Please accept my humble apology, Jim." Ladies and gentlemen, I, Chicken John, your humble servant, am laid low. Truly, it is Jim, with his billion-dollar intergalactic language archive apology prank, has trumped my water spigot and toilet paper jokes with celestial grandstanding and showboating. 1,000 eons from now, after our sun has gone supernova, and our ideas, convictions, libraries, our grand monuments, and our priceless treasures are nothing but cosmic dandruff, that disc will be out there. Our names and our humanity is clearly on display. The sentiment of that note, in 1,500 languages, will be one of the last vestiges and relics of the collected histories of our species. Let no man ever challenge the power of a prank and the innovation that comes from the collaboration in the arts. It can indeed change the world. I argue, nothing else ever has.